Hello everyone. Today I'll be teaching you English grammar and we will be learning about one of the most important topics of the parts of speech, that is prepositions. So now before we jump into the definitions and explanations of prepositions, let's first try to understand what these prepositions are. So let me make this little easy for you with the help of some demonstration. Now, if you see, in my one hand, I have this box, and in my other hand, I have this glue. Now, if I place the glue here, and if I ask you that where is the glue? So what can you say? That the glue is inside the box, right? Now, where is the glue? The glue is in front of the box. Now, if I place the glue here, so what can you say? That the glue is next to the box. Now, the glue is under the box. And now, the glue is behind the box. So, I just tried to place the glue at different positions, right? Correct? And you know all these words, under, on, behind, below, all these words tell you about the position, right? The position of the glue in respect to the box. So these are your preposition words. So in simple language, your prepositions are your position words. But if we go a little in detail, so let's try to understand prepositions in detail. If you look at this example here, yes, the cat is sitting under the table. So now in this sentence, the word under helps us to form the relation between the cat and the table, right? Correct? Suppose, for example, if we don't use the word under here, let's skip the word under. So if I say the cat is sitting the table, does this sentence make any sense? No. Not really, right? So we need the help of this word under. We need the help of this preposition under to form a link, to form a relationship between the cat and the table, right? So that's what your preposition does. So your preposition forms a relationship between a noun and the rest of the words in the sentence. And your rest of the words can be your noun, verb, or an adjective. So now if we have to form a definition of a preposition, so we can say that a preposition is a word that shows the relation between a noun or a pronoun and some other words in a sentence. So basically, your preposition helps to link, it helps to connect, it helps to form a relationship between the noun and the rest of the words in a sentence. So now I hope the concept of preposition is clear to you. Now let's study about the types of preposition. So basically, there are three main types of preposition, that is preposition of place, prepositions of time, and prepositions of direction. So to get the prepositions of place, you have to ask the question where. To get the prepositions of time, you have to ask the question when. And to get the prepositions of direction, you have to ask the question in which direction. So basically, these three words are important if you want to get the types of preposition. So remember these three words. They are where, when, and in which direction. Let's study them in detail. So first, let's go through preposition of place. So prepositions of place will tell you that where exactly someone or something is. So basically, it will tell you about the location of the thing or of the object, right? And some examples of these preposition words are under, above, over, in, on, and so on. Next, if we move to prepositions of time, so prepositions of time will tell you that when some particular event happened or when it will occur, right? Okay, so basically it talks about time. Some words that helps us to know the prepositions of time are in, on, at, before, after, and so on. Next, if we move to prepositions of direction. Now, prepositions of direction tells you that in which direction someone is going or coming from. So basically, it talks about the direction, right? So some examples are to, into, off, from, up, down, etc. Okay? So now let's try to solve this exercise with the help of the prepositions, and also let's try to find out the kinds of preposition in different sentences. So if we look at the first example, the boy is in front of the building, right? So here now, the boy, where is the boy? Okay, so when we ask the question where here, so we get the answer that the boy is in front of the building. So in front of is the word that helps you to know that where the boy is, right? So in front of becomes your preposition here. So it becomes, and it is answering the question where, so it becomes preposition of place. Okay, now next, if we move on to the second sentence, Rina will meet you at 6 p.m. in the park. So when will Rina meet you? At what time? So she will meet you at 6 p.m. So at is your preposition here, and at is talking about time. So that's why it becomes your preposition of time, right? Next, if we move on to the third sentence, Rahul is coming from the school. So where is Rahul coming from? From the school, right? So from which direction he's coming? He's coming from the school. So from is telling you about the direction that Rahul is coming from. So that is why this year from becomes your preposition of direction. Okay, so this was all about preposition and its kind. I hope the concept is clear to you now. Thank you.